Hello, everybody. Thanks for tuning in to another plan with me. I'm just showing you here my previous spread that I did for the previous week, January 29th through February 4th. And if you're interested in taking a look at that, I'll include the description, the link in the description box below. This week, I decided to use a Valentine's kit that I got with the Sticky Station and Stick With Me Shop collaboration. As well, I'm just flipping through what comes with the kit. This was like a limited time thing, so if you weren't able to get it whenever they had it on, either by following their Instagram and they were going to give you time that they were going to post it, then unfortunately you may have missed out. However, both of these shops do have very cute kits, so it's not, if you miss this, there will be other designs that you probably would like if you peruse both of their shops. And I purchased this with my own money, so all thoughts and opinions are my own. But as I get started here, I am putting down the bottom washi on both sides. And I was just readjusting the bottom washi on the second half. You're gonna see me doing a lot of readjusting because it looks correct whenever, or it looks straight whenever I put it down, and then I lift it back up and, you know, I try and put it down again, but I ended up putting it down. I think it was even more crooked when I put it down the second time. So I just used that as a sign to just leave it there and, you know, continue on with the rest of the spread. And even though I pulled the sticker up a lot, the actual planning paper did not tear with it. So I thought that was pretty interesting. Something that I liked. And I went ahead and started putting down the date covers for the first portion, Monday through Wednesday. And the Monday portion did kind of come up and cover a tad portion of the Y in February, but I mean, it's not anything that's super noticeable. Initially, with the date covers and then the actual date covers, there's a sheet of 31 of them. I'm pretty sure I can find a way to use the rest of them, probably in that monthly overview that I did, but I'm aware that there's gonna be like 7 days that aren't there, so I'm fine with it. I'll figure out something to do with it. But after I put down the date covers, I know you can see some of the bleeding through from the previous week's spread. So I thought this was a good time to kind of use a kit that had a lot of full box stickers to kind of cover that. And that is something that you also wanted to keep in mind whenever you are using certain felt tip pens. Some of them do I think they refer to it as ghosting. I'm not quite sure if the term is ghosting, or I say bleed through, but you guys kind of get the idea. Whatever term you feel comfortable using, by all means, use it. But the Recollections felt tip pen is like that. I'm not quite sure if the Papermate felt tip pen is like that. That's something else that I'll probably try out, because I ended up going to Staples and I got some more paper and pens. I can't help myself. Everyone who knows me knows I've been that way since I was a little girl. School shopping, I was interested in the pen aisle and the paper aisle. That was the only thing that was school supplies. I didn't care about the clothes, believe it or not. But back to this plan with me here. I went ahead and put down a full box sticker, and pretty much it says, "You will forever be my always." I thought it was a cute decorative sticker, and I have been using this gold foiled abstract pattern washi tape. I really think it's really beautiful, and it goes with the spread as well, especially because there were gold undertones with it as well. At the last minute, I decided to cover the page flag for February, and the page flag was a little bit smaller than the page flag for the planner, but again, I think the pink highlight actually ended up looking like a nice shadow to it, so it worked out. For the weekly tracker, there's just some things that I wanted to be grateful for, or that I was grateful for. And then I did another weekly tracker because I've been having a cough, and because I'm like asthmatic, I always have a cough, but these coughs are a tad bit different. You know, I can tell my coughs, if that makes sense. And this is one where I'm like trying to notice for cough and sneeze and stuff like that. Since this is kind of like a crazy flu season, I'm just, you know, tracking stuff for my own purpose. But I went ahead and I put at the bottom portion, "It's a plan," and another decorative sticker before going into Monday. And I decided to actually straighten my hair. I haven't straightened my hair for probably like a year, so anyone who has like curly or tightly coiled hair knows when you straighten your hair, that's like your whole day is straightening it, especially if you're doing it yourself and not getting it professionally done. It takes a while even getting it professionally done. But I just wanted to be able to throw it back and just not have to worry about it for a minute. So that's kind of what I did. I did some reading. I just caught up with my sisters via phone. I did some doodling and my daily YouTube binge as well. And I also went ahead and did some online work, and there was also some online shopping that I did, or at least I was doing perusing and some shopping. I went ahead and went into Tuesday, and I wanted to go ahead and check for the delivery for some other items that I had ordered, and literally they said it was supposed to be delivered like the 14th or something like that. And they delivered it on, I think they had delivered it on the 8th, which bothered me because I've never seen such a drastic, a huge span of something being delivered and being delivered so early. But this was the only time I wasn't happy because it was delivered. I was timing it to where it would be delivered to my new apartment, and it ended up getting there before the date that I needed it. Let's just put it that way. But I mean, lesson learned for myself, just don't trust delivery dates, I guess is probably the whole motto. Outside of that, I went ahead and cooked lunch. I took a nap that day. I decided to do some monthly overviews for the month of February. If you guys look at my Instagram, Gabby Quiet Girl, you'll go ahead and see the post I did for that. I also ended up having brunch with my dad, brunch lunch, something like that. And pretty much I did some cleaning, and I'm cleaning because I know eventually I'm going to be packing. So kind of two birds with one stone type of deal is what I'm trying to do. But that's why I put the full box down just to kind of symbolize that that was going to be taking a lot of my time before going into Wednesday, and just kind of putting in some of the things that I was doing, hand lettering practice, reading, packing. I'm also catching up with my sisters who, you know, aren't in the current state as me. Furniture shopping as well. And I did watch a movie, Whatever Happened to Monday on Netflix, which I thought was, I liked the movie. It was a lot of twists and turns. And I liked the actress too that played it. She played several different parts as well. But the new apartment list supplies, I also was writing down lists there. And pretty much that I was packing. And then I pretty much just did some more decorative stickers putting down before going in to the second portion of the week, and then going ahead and matching that first page flag with the second half as well. I went ahead and put down the date covers, and I put down Thursday and actually took it off. I wanted to kind of, off of my memory, just realize that it was a tad bit up from the box, but not too much. And Sunday I knew was going to cover the page flag, so I wasn't too worried about that. While I put the actual date covers on top of the day cover stickers, and then I put down the countdown of Valentine's. That was one of the main reasons that I decided to use this particular kit before Valentine's week, especially because there was a countdown. And I'll plan to probably do another Valentine's kit for the actual, not like a Valentine themed spread for the week of Valentine's as well. And for Thursday, I went ahead and put down the today header, which was so cute because it had a little heart next to it. And I just wrote down some of the other things that I wanted to do. Check on my Etsy order, as well as check on TVs. In the process of getting a new television. When I had moved, I ended up giving my other television away to a friend, so Yeah. And also, yeah, just checking in with family members, with my sisters a lot. I just like to bounce ideas off of their, you know, and see what they're thinking. But I went ahead and put down another washi tape header, and I kind of put down this full box, which I think the heart stickers was actually the prettiest part of the kit. I thought that was so pretty. They could have actually did the whole spread with that, and I would have been happy. But it's fine that, you know, it's not. I thought it was perfect how it was. I put down a page flag that said, yay. When this was from the Agenda 52, I was a little bit worried because even though it was pink, I felt like, well, what if this pink clashes? But looking more into it, there's other pinks that kind of match with that. And pretty much, I thought that was a happy day for me because I was getting stuff done and I knew that I had to actually make a trip on tomorrow to kind of have a package moved. From the apartment office that I was staying in into the actual apartment, even though I don't move in, they were kind enough to let me move it in. And then I noticed that on the 10th, they had delivered another package that was early. This was from a different company, so I don't know. I guess they'll always deliver packages early is what I'm thinking, or maybe because not too many people are ordering furniture like that. It's not the holidays. That's what I'm probably thinking is what's going to happen. But long and short of it, I got the packages. I'll open them on Monday and see, make sure that they're not damaged or anything like that. And I'll keep you updated with that. But I used two glitter headers. I thought this was kind of like a nice contrast over this little half box. And I put down that I wanted to do more hand lettering practice, and that's kind of what I've been doing off camera. I actually did film I got this little hand lettering kit from Crayola, it's Crayolography. I didn't end up posting it because I put Happy Holidays at the end of it, but I'll probably post it sometime. Not quite sure when. I just have to edit it a little bit more, but I don't actually do any hand lettering in that actual video because I'm not in the position to really teach anyone how to do it because I'm so fairly new to it myself. So just one of the things that I kind of want to get better at, that's kind of like one of my yearly goals, my yearly writing goals. But for Friday, I put down a road trip and then I put an Ikone shop sticker down. No, it wasn't a flight, but still the same as traveling. And pretty much moved some of the items. I took a few items with me as well. So I was like, well, let's just make this trip count. I wanted to take a lot more stuff because I know the day that I'm moving in, it's going to be raining. But my dad was like, oh, no, you know, don't take all of that. I don't know. He's really by the book, which sometimes doesn't necessarily work in this day and age because it just doesn't. But, you know, just out of respect, I just listened to him. I was like, okay, well, we took a few items. We placed it there. I think he was concerned that some of the things would, you know, you technically don't have access to your apartment till the 12th, so I kind of get what he was saying, but, you know, whatever. No complaints here, but, yeah. Also, got my brakes done via my dad, so thank you, Dad, for that. And I also did some reading. And, again, I've been checking up on order status, and then ended up having lunch. I believe lunch was at a buffet, if I'm not mistaken. I don't know why I can't remember which day that was, but I believe it was Friday. And then I went ahead and checked some of the emails as well. I went ahead and set up the background for the weekend banner, and I put it down, but I didn't like how it looked. And then I put down again, and I was like, okay, well, it's just going to be just the sides. And then I was like, no, I'm going to go crazy, and I'm going to cover this whole section with gold foiled washi tape. And that's exactly what I did. So that's what you see me doing right there. I was like, okay, I'm going to wipe that out and keep going. And I was like, okay, does that look fine? And I filled it up again. I was like, no, let's put some more down. Just cover everything. So that's exactly what I did. And I thought it was nice because I thought just the abstract pattern, then the weekend. You can't even tell that they're going at different angles, which I love when that happens with washi tape. And then I put movie night, even though it was during the day. I went and saw that movie Coco. I wanted to see it when it first came out, but you know, yes, I was the only adult in there with no child watching the movie, but it was still a great movie. And at the end, I did get teary-eyed, so it's still a good watch if you haven't seen it. I won't tell you exactly what it's about in the event that you haven't seen it, and I don't want to spoil it for you, but it's a good watch, especially by the time this post, it'll probably, it still is in theaters. But after I came home, I ended up catching up with my family members over the phone, talking with my mom, and I also filmed the plan with me and took the pictures for the plan with me. And then on Sunday, what I normally do is just kind of do some inspirational things and post a plan with me and stuff like that. And then as I'm packing, pretty much just listening to, you know, watching television, some of my favorite shows, just kind of keeping myself entertained while I do some packing. And I went ahead and put some more gold foil under this full box sticker with the pig with the heart eyes, and I thought that was cute there because pretty much that was just about to kind of Sunday night, that it's a combination of packing and just kind of doing planner stuff. So that's why it was a large box that I decided to use. At this point, I'm just putting down other decorative stickers, and that's pretty much the completed spread that I have actually using this kit, which I think is really cute as well. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it as much as I enjoyed planning it, and I hope that you guys have a very wonderful weekend and have a great Valentine's Day if you guys do celebrate it. Take care.